Hello, students. Welcome to our virtual music room. Our lesson focus for today is music history, the classical, romantic, modern, and contemporary periods. We will be highlighting historical periods of music. The purpose of this lesson is to introduce students to modern periods of music history and the contributions made by composers, musicians, musical instrument inventions, and the expansion of musical elements. Our objectives for today are: number one, I can name and identify three modern periods of music and describe the characteristic of each. Number two, I can list composers for the classical, romantic, modern, and contemporary periods of music. Number three, I can define the words classical and romantic. And number four, I can identify classical, romantic, modern, and contemporary period instruments. Our South Carolina College and Career Ready Standards are Anchor Standard 6, I can analyze music. Anchor Standard 8, I can examine music from a variety of stylistic and historical periods and cultures. And Anchor Standard 9, I can relate music to personal meaning, other arts disciplines, other subjects, and career paths. Our artistic processes are responding and connecting. So, let's get started. What are the three latest or modern periods of music history? What does the word classical mean? What does the word romantic mean? Can you name a classical composer? Can you name a romantic composer? What are some classical instruments? Boys and girls, the answers to these essential questions will be explored today in our lesson on music history, the classical, romantic, modern, and the contemporary periods. The seven musical periods are classified as medieval, Renaissance, Baroque, classical, romantic, modern, and contemporary, with each fitting into an approximate time frame. Today, boys and girls, we will discuss the classical, romantic, modern, and contemporary musical periods. The classical period was an era of classical music between roughly 1730 to 1820. Classical music has a lighter texture than Baroque music and is less complex. A variety of keys, melodies, rhythms, and dynamics, along with frequent changes of mood, timbre, and were more commonplace in the classical period than they had been in the Baroque period. The term classical started to gain traction in European culture just at the moment when the music industry was heating up as orchestras were being established, concert halls constructed, music instruments manufactured, and there was a boom in music publishing. The first great master of the classical style was the composer Joseph Haydn. Other famous classical musicians include Ludwig van Beethoven and Wolfgang Amadeus Mozart. Boys and girls, to get a better understanding of the classical period, let's watch the enclosed video on early music history. Here we go! That was an informative video, boys and girls, highlighting the classical period of music. Let's now talk about the Romantic period. The Romantic period of music is from 1830 to 1900. The Romantic period was a time when composers, artists, and authors moved away from the formal restraint of the classical period. The word romanticism was first used to describe new ideas in painting and literature towards the end of the 18th century. This word was later taken up by musicians to describe the change in musical style, which took place soon after the turn of the century. Unlike classical composers, Romantic composers aimed for a store powerful expression of emotion, often revealing their innermost thoughts and feelings. As Romantic composers widened their music material, we find richer harmonies, more passionate melodies, and greater use of chromaticism. There was an enormous increase in the size of orchestras, boys and girls. The tuba was added to the bass section. The piccolo, bass clarinet, and double bassoon were added to the woodwind section. the Romantic era to produce many more composers whose names and music are still familiar and popular today. Brahms, Tchaikovsky, Schumann, Schubert, Chopin, and Wagner are perhaps the most well-known, also Liszt, Verdi, and Mendelssohn composers. Let's watch the enclosed video, boys and girls, on romantic music. Are you ready? Okay, here we go.
The Romantic period between 1800 and 1850 was a reaction against the Industrial Revolution in what is referred to as the Age of Enlightenment. It is associated with liberalism and radicalism and attempted to capture raw emotions through music. Romanticism in music was a largely German thing because we all know Germans are known for being romantic. Composers of note from this period include Brahms, the child genius, who was performing at 8 and improvising sonatas by 11. Wagner, whose collection of epic operas, The Ring Cycle, lasts around 16 hours. Wagner was expelled from law school for dueling and gambling. I guess music was his backup. And Liszt, a dazzling pianist whose work included many trills, arpeggios, and large leaps. He made a series of preludes about his personal struggles, passions, and mysteries. But no one knows what it was a prelude to. He's hiding something, the sneaky goose. Others include Verdi, Berlioz, Tchaikovsky, and Rossini. The bar for romantic music was set by Beethoven in the classical period, which you all know about from our previous video. Aside from these composers, other noteworthy individuals from this period include author Edgar Allan Poe and artists Friedrich and Goya. Composers from this period were less concerned with entertaining their audiences and more into fulfilling their own musical dreams. Staples of the Romantic era included large orchestras, which included percussion instruments like celestas, drums, harps, and bells. Woodwind sections brought in the contrabassoon, bass clarinet, and piccolo. Pieces of romantic music were also generally longer, with dramatic changes in mood, implying spontaneity in compositions was a direct reaction against the strict and predictable structures of classical music. And this allowed musicians to explore a deeper emotional connection to their art. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video or
That was an enlightening video, boys and girls. The final periods that we will highlight today are the modern music period and contemporary period. Music really started splitting into categories during the modern music era from 1910 to 2000. This is where you get styles like Impressionism, Modernism, Ragtime, Jazz, Blues, Rock and Roll, Soul, Rhythm and Blues, Disco, and more. The contemporary period of music is from 1945 to the present day. It commonly is referred to as the post-1945 modern forms of post-tonal music and includes serial music, electronic music, experimental music, minimalist music, pop music, hip-hop, rap, and more. Boys and girls, to get a better understanding of modern and contemporary periods, let's watch the enclosed video on pop music. Here we go!
Listen, heartbreaking. Oh, Johnny, go, go. Oh, Johnny, be good.
Fly me to the moon. Let me play up there with those stars. Let me see what life is like on Jupiter and Mars.
But I'll go, baby, I say it, we gotta go. Serving USA.
Boys and girls, that was a motivating video. Here's your assignment for today. I want you to write in your music journal the names of three composers that were featured in our lesson today. Here's your assignment again. I want you to write in your music journal the names of three composers that were featured in our lesson today. That's your assignment. Boys and girls, I hope you have enjoyed today's lesson. Here's a summary of today's lesson. The periods of music or music eras are ways in which musicians classify the history and development of Western classical music over the last 1500 years. They help us understand how music has changed. The seven musical periods are classified as medieval, Renaissance, Baroque, classical, romantic, modern, and contemporary, with each fitting into an approximate time frame. Each musical period covers a specific date range. Although these should be considered to be approximate, there is always significant debate as to the point where each era ends and the next begins. Each musical period or era has its own characteristics that are typical of that era. Each era has famous composers. Also, crucial features of any period of music is the advancement of instruments, developments in the use of melody, harmony, and rhythm. The classical period was the era of classical music between roughly 1730 to 1820. The Romantic period of music is from 1830 to 1900. Music really started splitting into categories during the modern era of music, boys and girls, from 1910 to 2000. The contemporary period of music is from 1945 to the present day. Boys and girls, I hope you have gained some knowledge and the awareness of the contributions made by composers, singers, and musicians of the classical, romantic, modern, and the contemporary periods of music. Please continue to strive to make music a part of your everyday life, boys and girls. As your music teacher, it is my duty and job to develop, foster, and implement a curriculum that will aid in discovering the gifts and talents in every student and prepare all of my students for middle and high school music courses, vocal and instrumental ensembles, and other arts clubs and organizations. Enhancing your music literacy and music appreciation, boys and girls, is essential in all of you becoming lifelong learners, creators, consumers, and advocates of music. For more musical fun, you can visit my virtual music classroom at www.gwensmithmusicroom.com. You can enjoy singing and watching the Song of the Month videos, visit the Digital Music Library, Instrument Room, Game Room, and more. See you there! Boys and girls, it's also essential that you continue to soar and fly high and be a superstar and shine for success every day. Boys and girls, I want you to have a great day, and I will see you on next week. I'm so glad we had this time together, just to have a laugh or sing a song. Seems we just get started, and before you know it, comes the time we have to say goodbye.